My God, there's water there, ain't there, Bubba?
That's ice down cold, ain't it?
Well, you know, the only bad thing about this being there on this good water, a little fisherman can come upstream anytime, you know. Being set up right in here would be kind of dangerous. We're up there on the hill. Ain't nobody gonna see us up there.
Let's go up there and check it out.
You know, we're in the Appalachian Mountains. There's good water everywhere.
Well, by God, we found a laurel thicket, didn't we?
But finding good coverage and a good flat surface to work in, that's gonna be the challenge.
You tell anybody been in here?
Right. We know they ain't gonna come, nothing come up this bank on us. And we can see a whole flat over through there, all the water.
My biggest concern is the sponginess of this ground. I mean, it's bad soft even way up here. We ain't got no foundation here. You know, I tell you what, I really like this spot that me and Jerry's found, but the ground is awful down spongy, and I'm scared once we clear out a hole in here and it rains on it two or three times, it's gonna get so muddy we can't work.
Let's wind our way on up through yonder and see what we can find.
Let's go, sir.
Let's see if we can get here on top of this flat right here.
Ground does seem to be a little firmer up here.
It's a little firmer right in here, ain't it? There's more foundation here, too.
It seems a lot drier. We got good foliage and stuff up top, so we got good cover. I think this is the spot, man. Tell you what, as we head on up with a little bit higher elevation, we run into a heck of a nice spot. We got even more canopy cover overhead, and the laurel is super thick.
We could clear out a little bit of this right here just in a circle, because there's nothing around that's gonna be touched.
It's perfect.
The spot is actually ideal that we're looking at here. The only thing with this place, it's gonna take a lot of work to clear it out to put what we need here to be successful for the season. We need some young blood come in here and run a chainsaw.
And trying to do it all by ourselves.
You've
nuts.
Had your health problems and all that stuff too.
I've got a guy in mind. He's a young guy. He's really good, hard worker. But there's something in the background that's bring a lot more to the table potentially than just a little bit of help. I'm not really going to tell Mike about him quite yet. I don't want to get Mike's hopes up too quick until we're ready for that.
I think this is it.
Well, we just got to figure on how we're going to get water up here. The only downfall is the place is above the water instead of the water being above us this time.
Well, water ain't no problem. We'll run us about a 2-inch black pipe up the side of this creek, weave it into the underbrush. We don't want to interrupt this seclusion with some kind of gas or noisy electric water pump or something like that. So we're going to have to get something that's going to be concealed real easy and super, super quiet, but still give us the water we need.
What you think? You think we got our spot?
Yeah, I'm happy with this spot.
I feel like we got the perfect place here. We get water to it, there's no reason why we can't start making liquor.
Sounds good to me.
Let's lock it in. God almighty, damn. Smells like mineral juice.
You ain't took that thing fishing, have you? One of these days, we're gonna learn to get these things clean before we actually put them away.
I know.
Well, I'll tell you what, with all jokes aside, man, I'm pretty tickled at our steel site. It's more secluded than we've ever been. I don't even think a hunter's gonna be able to find us.
Last season, we had some folks come in on us, and we're trying to eliminate that for this season. But it's gonna be a lot of work getting that place set up, you know what I mean?
Well, you know what they say. Where there's a will, there's a way, right?
Where there's a will, there's a way, brother. We've got a new site. It's way back in the woods. It's in the middle of a laurel thicket. It's gonna take a lot of work to clear it out, but I'm feeling really good about it, and I can't wait to get it started.
Well, that's starting to smell a little better.
Jerry, who's that right there?
I have no idea.
Mike Cockrell.
Richard Landry.
What's going on, Mike? How you doing, brother?
Me and Richard, you know, we go pretty far back now. We competed against each other on Master Distillers, and we both from the Deep South. We're good friends.
What in the hell are you doing up this way?
Man, I'm just riding. I love this beautiful scenery. Look where y'all at, man.
We're in a beautiful place, right?
Look at that. I don't never get to see nothing like that in life.
So you just out on a damn joyride.
That's all I'm doing, man.
I like going out on road trips and stuff, but I ain't everybody found my way to Louisiana.
Well, I mean, Mike told me he took a road trip from Mississippi. I mean, he wound up here in the mountains.
I live here, though. I've been here for 15 years. You know what I mean? Richard lives in Louisiana, and the price of gas is through the roof right now. I mean, that's a long down way just to be out joyriding.
Look, I got something real good. You know about that Moonshiner tea. You from the 1 mile marker.
Yeah.
Let me let you taste something.
Let's do it.
This is a Manglier corn that we did. Aged it a little bit.
Looks good.
Tastes pretty good, too.
Well, it smells good, buddy.
That's a good barrel it come out of.
I have to give you props. That's some good tasting liquor there, Landry. Is it selling good, or?
I cannot make enough of this stuff. But you know what? I'll be honest with you guys, man. I'm just sick of dealing with that bayou water. I'm in an area of the world where I got a truck water into me, man. This limestone water y'all got down here, man, is something totally different.
We got the best water.
Y'all think this liquor is good? I can make it better if I had water like you guys got here.
You wanting to set up shop around here?
I don't want to step on y'all toes. I'm just trying to make myself better.
Richard's got his game on, and he thinks he can up his game by coming here and finding better water.
You know, you can't just roll in somewhere and just automatically just set up camp. I mean, who are you working with? Where are you going to be doing this?
You got to know somebody.
I'm still working on all that right now.
You need something, you're more than welcome to holler at us. We'll do everything in the world we can to help you. You know what I mean?
All right.
I don't know what the hell Richard wants here.
Y'all take care.
All right, man.
All right, it's good seeing y'all.
But whatever he's doing here, he's got me worried. That Manglier tea, it's good stuff.
And having good water, you may make it better.
As bad as I friggin' hate to say it, we've got competition. We've got to up our damn game right now. We got to up the game.
Hey, look. I got us an ace in the hole. I got us somebody who I think is going to be able to help us, and he'll take care of things.
I'll get him to come by, let you meet him, see what you think about him.
Well, I've been with you long enough. I trust you.
We got this, man. Don't worry about it.
You know, old Richard, he knows what the hell he's doing. He makes damn good liquor. That could be a little bit worrisome. But Jerry says he has a guy that can help us out. You know, anything we can do to get an edge, we need it.
I found just the guy to help us. I got him coming by here in a little while, kind of hang out with us a little bit, see what you think.
You trust him?
Sure do.
Hey, I trust you. If you trust the guy,
good,
I don't
good hand,
care.
I tell you. You gonna screw this together, I'll hold it. I think Mike's probably a little on the concerned side. I mean, you know, as I would be not knowing this guy, but I know he's a hard worker. I've known him for quite some time. Also, on top of that, he's got some knowledge on some things that might just help us out tremendously.
Can't even walk in there right now, hardly.
Yeah, we definitely need to get in there and get cleaned up.
You're always nervous when somebody wants to bring somebody else into your steel site. You know, that's like, almost like letting somebody take your old lady out to eat. You just don't do that.
Well, looky there. Speak of the devil.
Where y'all up to?
What's going on, man? Mike, brother.
Nice meeting, family. I'm Solomon.
Solomon?
Sutton.
Sutton?
Yeah, boy.
Uh-oh. That is the guy with the Sutton last name. You any kin to old Popcorn?
Yeah, that's my dad.
Your daddy?
Yeah.
Hell, fire. I tell you what, your dad was known for making a lot of damn liquor, wasn't he?
What? Well, my dad was Popcorn Sutton.
As Bubba says, I'm gonna make some wiki today.
He ran liquor out here for a long time, up on Hemp Hill and all over Maggie Valley.
Biggest question is, can you work and do you want to work?
Oh, yeah.
You know, with Solomon being on board with us and that being his dad, can potentially set us up to sell a lot of liquor. We're gonna try this guy out, see how he works for us. If he'll work hard and keep his mouth shut at the same time, I believe we can all be friends.
Like I told you earlier, we found a nice big laurel thicket. We want to clear out the middle. We can get set up in there.
That works for me. I know it's going to be hard work and stuff, but moonshine is in my blood, you know? It's part of my history.
Gary, you want to take this man out and show him what he's going to be doing?
I said, let's do it.
All right.
Got your work boots on?
What's left of them. Well, it's thick, ain't it?
Popcorn Sutton, everybody in these mountains know who he is. Matter of fact, people far and wide know who he is.
We need a pretty big area so we ain't turning around and hitting in the damn limbs.
Solomon being Popcorn Sutton's son could be very beneficial. I mean, he's kind of legendary in this area that we're in. But not only just having that name, there may be tricks to the trade that he learned from either his dad or some other family members that's been in the business for years that might help us out a little bit.
All right, let's get out of your way so you can get your stuff doing.
Man, don't get all these stobs up. Somebody break your head off.
Look how space we got here already.
I know.
So our most important thing right now we need to do is we need to get set up for our water and clear us a path right up through
right
yonder.
Right up through there.
We can get us a good flat spot up there about, I don't know, 40, 50 yards up through there. We don't want to make this look like a highway coming through here. We want to cut as minimal amount of stuff as we can because we want everything to look, you know, secluded as much as possible.
Damn, it's so thick. All you can do to walk through here. We're getting somewhere.
Getting somewhere.
Slowly but surely.
I tell you what, this little cat knows how to work and run a chainsaw.
Right here behind this tree flattens out pretty good. Cut a little path out in there, that'd be a good spot to put the water barrel.
I believe it's gonna make some good liquor for us.
I think this makes a pretty good spot. I can see the creek right down there. I think we can go right off there, get a barrel set up here. That'd be a straight shot right through there, right over there on there.